So, 2 years ago, I started noticing that I was getting this awful stomach pain. Like, you had, like sheet metal or glass inside my stomach and my lower belly. My stomach would swell up to the size of a basketball. And, you know, there was a lot of gastric, without getting too graphic, you know, there was a lot of fucking, you know, waste issues, etc. This would happen every night. It was extremely painful, embarrassing, awful. And one night it got so bad that I honestly thought I was going to die. So I called an ambulance to come get me out of the bathtub because I couldn't stand up. And I was wheeled naked to the hospital. Actually, this is the boring part of the story. Let me get to the good part. Eventually, you know, I went to many, many doctors. I had to sort of go through extensive amounts of stool testing and other, you know, other exciting adventures. The last thing they had to screen me for was colon cancer, which the screening for that is what they give you, what's called a sigmoidoscopy. It's not like a colonoscopy where they put you out. It's they inflate your lower intestine with an air hose, which sounds exactly like the air hose that they use at a gas station to fill up your car tire. They put that in your ass after lubing you up with some sonogram jelly, and you're facing a wall of video cameras that are all tuned in to the camera that they're about to put in you. So first thing they do is they start up this machine. It sounds like a gas-powered machine inside this room. They stick it in your ass. It's hard to describe the sensation of having your ass fully inflated with a high-pressure air hose. You do feel like you are a beach ball or a tire, and you expand to a degree that you would not have thought possible. But all of this kind of pales in comparison to the actual camera, which is a long, thin steel wire that they then force into sort of delicately coiling tissue of your, you know, lower digestive tract. And, you know, jam it as far as they can go, all while telling you to relax, and all while you're watching the video feed of this sort of angry, convulsing red cave. And then, after the fact, you know, you have to release the air and the lube and whatever blood and chewed up bits of flesh have been, sort of, chewed off the walls of your intestines. And, I guess that's pretty much it. The denouement of the story is I did not have cancer, thank God.